September 1997, and the end of Shirley Bassey's concert schedule is in sight.
Tallest policeman I've ever seen. I'm sure he's a basketball player.
This is the story of her whirlwind winter tour, life on the road with a diva from Tiger Bay.
This is me.
Hello. They won't let me on. I'm going to take you.
Ticket this year.
Lift it up a little bit tight. Oh, one. Oh, great. Oh. What about that? Is it gorgeous?
This year is my life. This year is my life.
Another city, another show. Antwerp. 6 hours to go before the last sellout show, and tensions backstage are rising. The musicians are waiting for the Bassey entrance. Preparations in the dressing room are underway. Andrew McGowan, her personal assistant and confidant, is dealing with a delicate problem over one of the famous Bassey gowns.
Boy, that dress in the world. About 6 months ago, a can of hairspray exploded in the gown case, which Shirley still doesn't know. And since then, because they all got a bit gunky, they've needed pressing ever since, every time we go away. So I think this is the last show this dress may well do. They must be about 2.5, 3 years old. I mean, she's got dresses older than I am, and she still wears.
Andrew?
Yes,
that's yours.
Yes, they may have some. This way. A first sight of the stage, and there's a problem. Bassey makes half a dozen rehearsed entrances and exits during each show, and she can't see how she's going to get on and off in one of those fabulous frocks without risking falling down the stairs.
I don't think you can.
Why do they do that? We send them a plan.
There isn't, we've been looking at it, there isn't a proper way on.
Well, it's one time on, I have to stay on.
The stairs, we can't...
No, I mean from there to the stage.
Because of the angle for the ramp for you to climb.
Oh, it's going to be bloody awkward, I tell you.
We're going to go to the only...
It's going to ruin the act, because it means I cannot go off at all. It's going to ruin my entrances and exits.
New York. New York medley, please. Are you ready, Shirley? You ready, my dear?
Yeah.
Okay. Boom.
She's been a professional singer since she was 16, with a vast repertoire of songs. It's the sheer power of her voice that her fans love.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of this. New York, New York.
I've always attacked a song, but in the beginning everybody said, you know, I was the belter, which used to upset me a little. You know, Bassey belts the best. They didn't label me classical pop because nobody could see it was a little classical. They just called me either a pop singer or a belter.
It's up to you.
Last October, Bassey arrived in New York to play Carnegie Hall, one of her favorite venues. She's been coming here since the swinging 60s. All the greats have performed here. Judy Garland, Barbara Streisand, Aretha Franklin. But Bassey is undoubtedly the queen of Carnegie Hall.
Carnegie Hall, it's Shirley Bassey's home. In the next century, they will rename this hall Shirley Bassey Pavilion. I mean, they talk about Judy Garland, they talk about the great opera stars of the 40s and 50s, but Miss Bassi, she owns this hall, and her fans come out in droves.
We're here at a temple to worship a goddess.
Come hell or high water, I'm going to see you, I won't miss you, I love you, I love you, I'm mad about you.
When she comes down the aisle, you know, to say, hey, big spender, I pop out with, all right, I'm a big spender, and we have some big bills to be a big spender with.
The more we give her,
the more we get.
The more we get back. It's a marriage.
New York is special because of Carnegie Hall. The room is incredible. The sound is fantastic. It is a special night, but they are so outgoing. I mean, like the moment I walk out, they give themselves to me, and that's it for me. I'm home and dry, and I can't do anything wrong. More luggage.
Shirley, she's timeless. She has a tremendous energy. She has incredible spark. She dances, she sings, she's a great personality. I mean, she's unbelievable.
Ivana Trump is one of Shirley's closest friends. She's the one throwing the post-concert party.
You look great.
Yes, I am.
My friend is here, Vittorio.
The party's swinging, but the waiters appear to have forgotten the star of the show.
Nobody's offered me any champagne. Nobody's offered me any champagne.
I'll get yours.
Nobody's offered me any champagne. Look, give me a kiss. Give me a kiss.
Wide-eyed and frockless, RuPaul, the New York drag artiste, mingles with glitterati and friends who've jetted in from all over the world. They have come to pay homage.
You just arrived, or you leaving?
I'm sorry. No, I just arrived.
As you can tell, these are my fans. They've come all the way from Brazil and from Paris.
And I missed the show.
But as the champagne flows, Ivana's in for a shock when she finds out about Shirley's next venue.
Oh, that's cute.
And then with Taj Mahal, for two nights. I'm sorry, it's your ex. I'm sorry about that.
The Trump Taj Mahal is proud to present the original Bond girl, the legendary Shirley Bassey.
Donald Trump, Ivana's ex, the man with the Midas touch, invited Shirley to perform at one of his modest little casinos in Atlantic City.
With an unwavering appeal that spans more than four decades, Shirley Bassey's powerful voice and unparalleled magnetism.
While Shirley's out on a shopping spree, her business managers are negotiating terms for the concert in Antwerp. It's the diamond capital of Europe, and the team are looking to cut an unusual deal.
The diamond awards, I'm going to do an hour and a half. Approximately 60-minute show.
Right.
The production is excellent quality. They're going to treat her like a queen.
You've read the extra clause on the writer for the diamond earrings.
We won't settle for less. All
right. That's what Shirley's known for.
Exactly. And so, we cannot let her down.
Antwerp is the diamond capital of the world for Europe.
That's what we're mentioning.
For Europe.
That's what we're getting at.
Okay.
The only reason we're going.
Exactly.
Yes, he'll do it. So, it's whether they feel that there's, in all seriousness, we're going to make this to them, and we're going to say, you know, we'll do a trade-off.
Has an artist ever requested diamonds?
No. But, you know, we'll do a trade-off, you know, let's see what happens.
Hey world, I love. I'm going to temple.
Oh, do you want me to come off immediately there?
The last twice that you've sung this, you've caught me, because I wasn't prepared for you doing it.
That's something that brings me into that. It helps me to say, hey world.
Same place again, please, 31.
Hey world, I am what I am.
You want to do it like that?
As long as it gives me that.
Oh, yes, you'll get that, yeah.
Now, that's great if I remember to do it.
Shirley has a new single with the cult band Propellerheads. and she's here to shoot the video.
God, you're everywhere. Hi, Colin. Oh, I can hear you. Yes. That sounds familiar. Oh, a nice smell. Ooh, do you have any eel pies? eels. I've just been discussing eels.
We just always wanted to do like a song in the old style, like a sort of classic song. And we were thinking who could we possibly best ask to sing. And we both immediately thought for Shirley Bassey. And we did a demo of it and I sent it to her management. And a little while later we heard that she was up for doing it. When she just started singing the first few lines and that was like hairs everywhere.